Hey there, fellow science enthusiasts. Welcome back to our channel, Chemistry Concepts.
Today, we will explore the fascinating world of gas diffusion rates. More specifically, we will focus on the impact of molecular weight on the rate of diffusion. You might be wondering, what exactly is molecular weight? Well, molecular weight refers to the mass of a molecule, which is determined by the sum of the atomic weights of all its atoms.
So today's topic is: describe and explain the effect of relative molecular mass on the rate of diffusion of gases. What is diffusion? Diffusion is the spontaneous movement of particles from an area of higher concentration to an area of lower concentration. It's a fundamental process in nature, from the scent of a flower spreading through a room to the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide in your lungs. The experiment. Now, to understand the effect of relative molecular mass on diffusion, we'll conduct a simple experiment. We have two containers filled with gases. In one, we have hydrogen, H2, a very light gas, and in the other, we have carbon dioxide, CO2, a heavier gas. The prediction. What do you think will happen when we open the valves? Will both gases diffuse at the same rate? Now, let's open the valves and observe. Hydrogen will diffuse faster, and carbon dioxide will be slower. As you can see, hydrogen gas is diffusing much faster than carbon dioxide. This experiment demonstrates the effect of relative molecular mass on the rate of diffusion. Why does this happen? The rate of diffusion is inversely proportional to the square root of the molar mass. In simple terms, lighter gases diffuse faster than heavier ones. Hydrogen, with its low molecular mass, diffuses quickly, while carbon dioxide, being heavier, diffuses more slowly. This happens because lighter gases have higher average kinetic energies, and their particles move faster, leading to more frequent and energetic collisions, which promote faster diffusion.
Imagine a room filled with gas molecules. Some may be lighter, while others may be heavier. When these molecules are given the opportunity to spread out and move from an area of high concentration to an area of low concentration, a process known as diffusion occurs. But here's where things get interesting. The rate of diffusion is directly affected by the relative molecular mass of the gas molecules. Simply put, lighter gas molecules diffuse faster than heavier ones. Think of it as a race. Lighter molecules are like sprinters, nimble and quick, while heavier molecules are like marathon runners, slower and more cumbersome. This difference in diffusion rates can be explained by the kinetic molecular theory. Essentially, it states that gas molecules are in constant motion. Lighter molecules, due to their lower mass, move faster and collide with other molecules more frequently, allowing them to diffuse at a faster rate. On the other hand, heavier molecules have a higher mass, which means they move slower and collide less frequently, resulting in a slower diffusion rate. To put it into perspective, let's consider oxygen and carbon dioxide. Oxygen, with a smaller molecular weight, diffuses faster than carbon dioxide, which has a larger molecular weight. This is why oxygen can travel more efficiently through the respiratory system in our bodies. So, the next time you think about the air we breathe, remember that the molecular weight of gases plays a crucial role in determining how quickly or slowly they can diffuse. And that's the science behind faster or slower diffusion rates based on molecular weight. We hope you found this video informative and insightful.
Real-world applications. Understanding the effect of relative molecular mass on diffusion has real-world applications. For instance, it's why helium balloons rise. Helium, being lighter than air, diffuses out of the balloon faster, creating buoyancy. The same principle applies in industries where gas separation is crucial, like in the production of oxygen, nitrogen, and other gases. In conclusion, the effect of relative molecular mass on the rate of diffusion is a fundamental concept in chemistry. Lighter gases diffuse faster due to their higher kinetic energy and faster particle movement. Now practice some structured questions. Question number 1: Which of the following gases diffuse more slowly than oxygen? F2, H2, Cl2, CO2, CO, C2H2, CH4, NO, N2O. Hint: the rate of diffusion of a gas is inversely proportional to the square root of its molar mass. In other words, lighter gases tend to diffuse more quickly than heavier gases. Oxygen, O2, has a molar mass of approximately 32 grams per mole. Let's compare the molar masses of the given gases. First, we know what is molar mass, and how we can calculate molar mass. Molar mass is defined as the mass in grams of 1 mole of a substance. The units of molar mass are grams per mole. The molar mass of a compound can be calculated by adding the standard atomic masses, in gram per mole, of the constituent atoms. F2, fluorine, has a molar mass of about 38 grams per mole. H2, hydrogen, has a molar mass of about 2 grams per mole. Cl2, chlorine, has a molar mass of about 71 grams per mole. CO2, carbon dioxide, has a molar mass of about 44 grams per mole. CO, carbon monoxide, has a molar mass of about 28 grams per mole. C2H2, acetylene, has a molar mass of about 26 grams per mole. CH4, methane, has a molar mass of about 16 grams per mole. NO, nitric oxide, has a molar mass of about 30 grams per mole. N2O, nitrous oxide, has a molar mass of about 44 grams per mole. Comparing these molar masses to the molar mass of oxygen, O2, we find that F2, Cl2, and N2O have molar masses greater than that of O2, so they would diffuse more slowly than oxygen. Result. Therefore, F2, Cl2, and N2O diffuse more slowly than oxygen. Question number 2. A gas of unknown identity diffuses at the rate of 83.3 milliliters per second in a diffusion apparatus in which carbon dioxide diffuses at a rate of 102 milliliters per second. Calculate the molecular mass of unknown gas. Hint. You can use Graham's law of diffusion to calculate the molecular mass of the unknown gas. Graham's law states that the rate of diffusion of a gas is inversely proportional to the square root of its molar mass. The formula is as follows. Rate 1 upon rate 2 equals under root of m1 upon m2. Where? Rate 1 is the rate of diffusion of the first gas. Rate 2 is the rate of diffusion of the second gas. m1 is the molar mass of the first gas, unknown gas. m2 is the molar mass of the second gas, carbon dioxide. Data. Rate 1 equals 83.3 meters length per second. Rate 2 equals 102 meters length per second. And we want to find m1, the molar mass of the unknown gas. We can rearrange the formula to solve for m1. m1 equals r2 squared into m2 divided by r1 squared. To calculate m1, you'll need the molar mass of carbon dioxide, m2, which is approximately 44 grams per mole. m1 equals 102 milliliters per second 2 into 44 grams per mole divided by 83.3 milliliters per second 2. Now, calculate m1. m1 equals 102 squared into 44 g per mole e divided by 83.3 squared. Molar mass of the unknown gas m1 is approximately m1 equals 61.9 mole. Result. So, the molecular mass of the unknown gas is approximately 61.9 grams per mole. If you enjoyed it, please consider subscribing to our channel for more exciting scientific content. Thanks for watching. Coming up next, atomic structure and the periodic table. Describe the structure of the atom as a central nucleus containing neutrons and protons surrounded by electrons and shells. State the relative charges and relative masses of a proton, a neutron. Define proton number or atomic number as number of protons in nucleus of an atom. Define mass number or nucleon number as total number of protons and neutrons in nucleus of an atom.